Hi, my name is Brian. Today I'm going to present multi-view object detection using bipolar constraints within Clutter X-ray security imagery. So the problem that we are tackling is to use the information from multiple views of an X-ray scanner to improve threat item detection. The geometry describing this setup is known as the bipolar geometry. So in the bipolar geometry, given one point in one view, we cannot know where it should be in the second view. But instead, we can know where it must lie across a line. So this line is known as the bipolar line. And the bipolar line can be constructed using the fundamental matrix F. And this matrix can be constructed using the information of the projection matrices of each of the images and their relative position between the cameras. In case we don't have this information, we can still estimate F using a point matching between the views. So this is our case. We have an uncalibrated cameras where we don't know these parameters, so we are gonna try to estimate F. However, feature detection and matching in transmission imagery such as X-ray is not suitable. So under these circumstances, the multi-view information or integration has not been done before as far as we know. And to solve this, we propose to use object annotations to estimate the fundamental matrix. Given a point representing the 3D object center, the projection is to the each of the images is x-bar. However, we don't know this x-bar in each of the images, but we can approximate it with the bounding box centroid of the annotations that we got. So the way that we are going to do this is that each of the coordinates is modeled as the true point x-bar or y-bar plus a measurement error, which is an error with normal distribution and zero mean, and a mapping of the real object center to the bounding box center, which can be modeled as another error with non-zero mean. So the sum of these two errors can be just summarized as this one, and this error can be modeled as a normal distribution with non-zero mean and a standard deviation. After estimating F, we can obtain now a bipolar lines. Since we model the centroids as true correspondences plus an error, they will be slightly deviated from the bipolar line. We can model this distance using this equation, which is the equation for a point to a line, and we can expand the equation using the previous relationship. However, since this true correspondence is in the equation and it must lie in the bipolar line, this vanishes from the equation and we only obtain the sum of two normal distributed errors, which can be modeled as a normal distribution. Now we define a multi-view epipolar confidence, which is given a distance to the epipolar line. We can model this as the sum of the tails for this given distance, and we obtain this equation as the epipolar confidence. And we can see here in the image how, given a bounding box in one view, we can get an epipolar line in the second view, and the confidence now that you get far away from this epipolar line. Multi-view filtering can be summarized as follows. First, we got raw predictions from a standard detector, and then we obtained the epipolar lines for each of these predictions, and then we validate the bounding boxes by their epipolar confidence. So if they are far away from the epipolar line, they will have a bad or a really low epipolar confidence and they are gonna be eliminated. So that's the way we remove false positives. After this process, we just do non-maximum suppression and we get our final result. Our results are summarized in the following table. We train a YOLO version 3 for the standard detector. So for single view, we use YOLO version 3, and for the multi-view, which is our approach, we use the raw prediction of YOLO version 3 before non-maximum suppression. And we can see that the overall AP increased by a 2.2%, and the AP 0.5 increased by 2.8. But we still have some problems for large objects, as you can see here, that for laptops, it decreased a little bit. But in general, we got a really good performance. So we have to model probably with a better distribution or error for large objects. A qualitative assessment shows how our method deals with false positives. So some false positives are eliminated because of they are not in the first view or near an epipolar line. And in more challenging examples, we can see that sometimes two firearms are detected in one view, but only one firearm is detected in the second view. But in the first view, it's more complex. But our method deals with this and just eliminates the false positive in this case. In more challenging examples, it sometimes eliminates some objects that were actually detections, but they were eliminated because it wasn't found in the second view. As for conclusions, we were able to estimate the fundamental matrix using only the annotations of the bounding box centroids. And with this, we built an epipolar confidence that was able to reduce false positive. And with this approach, we improve our benchmark against single view by increasing the average precision by a 2.2 and the average precision of the COCO matrix using only 0.5 as the intersection over union increased 2.8%. And the recall was practically unaffected. Thank you very much.